So again, what do we know about the participants and what they've been saying? Hopefully, we've been able to support the good work that's happened by others. So a patient, one of the patient quotes, "I learned a lot from everyone on how to stay healthy and how to stay alive. It feels so good to hear my doctor say, I'm coming along great, I'm doing well, and I could not have done it alone." So that appreciation of the team, we saw that in spades in the other client vignettes. And from several physicians, some quotes that came in on some of the surveys we were doing, the best thing that has come out of the project is our relationship with the CCAC, and that having the CCAC as part of the team has made that large organization more real for us. So putting that human face and creating that relationship. So what to from here? There was significant financial support that was part of this project to us and to others who have been involved in us, and we all then I find myself today engaging and listening so carefully and celebrating the successes at the same time that the other half of my brain is saying, how do we keep this going and how do we keep this moving forward and sustain? It's not good enough to just sustain this, what you are doing. We have to spread this to the other 600 or so family physicians across the Southwest. So how do we do that? So there's a panel this afternoon that will focus on that. But certainly from our end, the development of an integrated care team with primary care is a given. And so we are moving forward with a whole new population-based model so that behind the scenes, the way that we're organized is going to be looking at those complex, frail, elderly patients and having case managers focus on those, as well as with chronic disease, learning from this project and understanding that we need to have a face-to-face contact with every primary care physician, and that the focus on self-management and on the proactive pieces that have been in place here, that must continue. The implementation of, as I said, that population-based approach to case management. Also, that data, you can't manage what you don't measure. And so if you're not looking at something in terms of a quantitative measure, then probably we aren't all focused on improving it. So that's been a key lesson here, and we are very, very grateful that the Government of Ontario, as part of its diabetes strategy, has announced regional coordinating centres for diabetes in each of the 14 LINs in the Southwest. We're pleased that the CCAC was able to take that role on, and that from those dedicated resources which are falling into place now, there hopefully will be an opportunity. You know, if you think of the catcher's mitt, when this project expires later this fiscal year, by then will the RCC be able to act as a catcher's mitt for some components of this to keep this going? The quality improvement methodology. The fact that PDSAs have become in common parlance for everyone in this room, we now have to keep that going and spread that across all of the other aspects of our healthcare system. Again, gratefully here, the Southwest LIN is funding a whole quality and process improvement strategy, which the CCC and others will be part of. There'll be a whole advisory committee on that element. And again, can that be another one of those catcher's mitts that can step in here and form part of the pieces to keep moving this forward? More client information sharing. We think that the electronic advances in technology that have happened with some of our systems, particularly Chris, we've just started to scratch the surface. We implemented our last site going live with that electronic health record in March. So it's a grand total of 6 months old to us. So we're just beginning to scratch the surface on the electronic enablers that can come out of that system and how we can continue to do that, as well as the healthline.ca, that single source of truth, and how can that continue to, again, be one of those catcher's mitts. It's going to be there long after this project, and how can it potentially continue to act as that single source of truth for the project? So with that, again, I just wanted to thank everyone on the CCAC team who stepped up to the plate. They too were pioneers within our organization. As some of those early meetings where you're sorting out roles and people don't even know why a case manager might be there, you know, there's some challenging dynamics to work through, and these dedicated care professionals managed to create relationships, create a shared understanding, and co-create the solutions that we hope have enabled you to achieve all of the success that we're clearly here celebrating today. So thank you.